This is my second video on PowerPivot. Now, I found this data on the internet as sample data, so I assume it's fictitious, but I have 9,000 rows of data here. I created a table and I've linked it to my PowerPivot by clicking on this to add to a model, and now it's put into my PowerPivot function. What I will show you is when it's in here, it looks very much like what it did before. So what we're going to do is, previously we created a pivot table, but let's create something else here. Below the pivot table, we have a drop-down list. And so let's create a dashboard of sorts. And so what we're going to do is we're going to create four charts on one page. And it's asking us, this is back on our Excel sheet, and yes, I'd like it on a new sheet. We have our worksheet with four charts on it. So to see the field types, we need to have a field list so we can put things on here. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to the Analyze part of the Pivot Tools chart here, and we're going to go Field List. Now it will show us our table and all the fields that we have in here. Okay, so I am going to drag and drop into the different parts of the pivot table chart here. And so what I'm going to first do is I'm going to take states. So I'm going to put state as axis. And then I am going to put, I'm going to total the sales for each state. So that's going to be my first chart. And so there you have the chart, or the states and their sales for each one of them. So on the next chart, I would like the categories of the products that they sold. Let's break down to, we get categories. And we're going to put that one there. And then I'm going to put subcategory as well underneath that. And then I'm going to total up the amount of sales that they had for each category and subcategory. So I'm going to drag sales into the sum value here. What they sold, the category is furniture, office supplies, technology, and there's the totals of all of this. We'll go down to our third chart. And I think on my third chart, I'm going to click on this and I'm going to change chart type. And I'm going to change it to a pie, and I think that one looks nice. And so I'll say okay. And now I'm going to select for this pie chart, I would like the categories and the total sales by each. So I'm going to select my values, and I would like categories. And then I'll have total sales of each. So there we have a nice pie chart done for us. So we have furniture, office supplies, and technology. So for my fourth chart, I am going to go sales as the bottom axis, and quantity as the total value here. So there you go. So now, this is looking pretty good, but let's put a slicer on here just to change things up. So let's go up to the top here. And what we're going to do is I'm going to make a little space here. So I'm going to push these things out a little bit. And then I'm going to go to my, on my analyze chart, I'm going to go insert slicer. And I'm going to have a slicer by the state, so I'm going to see what part of the state is buying more of each product. So I'm going to select state from here and say OK. So here we have our states in between there. So now let's drag this across so you can see. And so now right at this moment we have everything in there. So let's see what California bought. And so that's what they bought. They bought more office supplies, it seems, or different amounts of them. And let's see what Delaware bought. and it all changes. So with, from the slicer in Florida, see what they bought. In Illinois. So from the slicer, you get to see different views of your pivot table that you have, or your pivot charts that you have created on your PowerPivot. This is one more aspect of the PowerPivot. Please subscribe.